Ends. Ooh, I don't want that. That's okay. Let's see what happens. All right, Monday, week number four, August 31st to September 4th. This week, you're learning about stem plots and histograms, a learning goal. Students will be able to understand how to display quantitative data on notes in your homework. Going over game plans and announcements. I have next slide. I have some school announcements. We're going over the week number four. I glance is kind of showing the week so you can understand what's going on. I probably spent last week about 10 hours updating your grades. I have to look at spreadsheets when you turn in things. And we'll talk about specific ones that are late and things you can still turn in for free. Super important one. Friday we took a quiz. So if you did not take the quiz, make sure to email me. I had a student last period do that. And that way I can release the scores tomorrow and then I can release the solution video. Last Friday, you've turned in assignments 1.1 to 1.3. That's the lessons and homework. So I'll show you guys a visual of that later on. Remember, your work from now on is handwritten. And we'll talk about grades and turning in late work and the penalties for that. Your participation grade updated. Participation grade is based on the check and connects coming into class. And the first 3 weeks of school, there were 12 days, minus the very first day that we were not checking in. And I counted it out of 10. So if you look at your grade, it is possible some of you guys actually have 12 out of 10, which is extra credit. I took 2 days off for any absences or tech issues. If you lost a lot of participation points because of you didn't have the hotspot or whatever it is, let me know. And if you're a new student, you're starting today. Remember, every Tuesdays and Thursdays, I have office hours. It's a great way of just checking in, any questions you might have. And you have to do the check and connect that I will put on your Schoology updates. All right, Ms. Cortez sent an email. Distributions this week, so take a look at your times. And also bring back any old stuff you have from last year. Okay, so I have this top four things that students are doing in class and how to remedy those things. So I have stops. Don't do this, slow down some mornings, and goes. So this is actually how you do it properly. Number one, unclick your Google document notifications. What do I mean by that? So they're in green number one. Usually you'll turn in, you're using Google documents to kind of operate as a tool, and usually you'll go into the share button and then you'll get to pick who you're going to share it with. And then do they have editing rights, can they comment or view? And to do it properly, you're just going to unclick. Do not notify me. The reason why, in this picture up here, is I get hundreds of emails saying, student has shared so-and-so slides or documents with you. I do not check those. I do check them, but I'm not turning it as for grades. The portal you're doing that is through Schoology. So this will minimize you sending me the emails. The reason why I had 25,000 emails in five years, that's 5,000 emails per year divided by 200, so maybe like 250 emails per day. And distance learning, you're probably looking at a little bit more than that. So I'm looking at like 250 to 400 emails a day. So it is impossible to keep track of those and all the things I need to do. So do not notify me. That was number one. Number two, do not send emails to turn in your assignments. Some students like to panic and they'll send me an email. So do not send an email with your attached assignment. If I specifically ask you, it's a super rare case. But remember, in yellow, only the first assignments, your e-sign, motivational quote, Khan Academy, Edulastic sign-up, and I forget what it was, student survey, or those were all turned in the first week. Those were the Google Forms. That was the only time you're turning it through Google Forms. The rest of them are going through Schoology. Okay? And you turn it in when it's all done, like a packet. Okay, so if you need help, this slide talks about how to turn in assignments through Schoology. So this video here on the left tells you how to connect your Google Drive to Schoology if you haven't already. And this video over here tells you how to turn in your assignments through Schoology. It's a teacher going through it from a student's perspective. Now, this one's super practical. I even emailed a student about this morning, okay? In Schoology, I'll create an assignment page for a week. So like right now in week number 4, I'm not gonna have one. Last week, I think I had it because I'm not a student, I'm just a teacher. And students are telling me this was the best way for them to turn in assignments. Students have told me that they've taken pictures of their work, uploaded the pictures to a Google document or Google Slides. From there, they press file, download as a PDF file, and then they upload the PDF file to Schoology. And they found that best to work because it doesn't like change the work or anything like that. Students have issues of even uploading links. So this is what students have told me. Those students who have said that was helpful, that's why I'm sharing it to you. Do you have to do it that way? No, but I've noticed the ones that have been turned in through PDFs are super easy. I like it. So I can, in the Schoology on my side, I can actually zoom in and zoom out. It works well. Number 3, no name or period on emails. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys a real life example from yesterday. Subject, so the student had in yellow box there, Edulastic, that was helpful. But as you look in this email, the student doesn't have a name or period, and so I have to ask, who is this? So it is super helpful when you clarify, hey, this is Jason from first period. That's super helpful for me to help you get what you need. So just label your emails. Subject, name, period. Super helpful. And the last one, stop expecting things to be done instantly. There was a student who turned in something and it was 2 weeks late and they expect them to grade it on the spot. Okay. Hopefully I'm treating you like a human being and you also treat me like a human being. We're not robots. I have a motto for work. Maybe you pick this up for as a student. Person first, business second. Hopefully I treat you as a person, flesh and blood, as important. And then what you do for my class, what grade you have as second. I just got an email from a student who was in my class 2 years ago. They're now at Cal State Fullerton or Fullerton College. And I remember the student. I don't remember what grade they got. But I remember the student, and the student has a message for you guys. Don't throw away your notes. She's actually taking statistics, and she threw away all her notes, and then she said, Mr. Ng, you told me not to, and I did it. And now she has to start from scratch. She realizes where you were in this position, so don't do that. So those are my top 4s. All right, school spirit, wear those. Tomorrow is neckwear. Office hours, drop by tomorrow. If you get lost, there's a one pager here. If you're brand new to the class, for statistics, I have your Schoology link there, a syllabus, and then under pacing, you can actually click on the past 4 weeks. So we're in week number 4. You can look back at what we've done for weeks 1, 2, and 3. Week 1, I don't have a video, and the rest of the ones, I have videos that talk, like a 5-10 minute video of me talking through what we have to do for the week. Okay, so I have this running tally or running page of assignments, okay? And I've also color-coded it a little bit more thoroughly. So if you're learning to drive, red means late. I've checked these. I spent about 10 hours last week, easily 10 hours, looking at the spreadsheets, even checking it multiple times. You know, some student had requested restrictions on their document maybe 3 or 4 times, and I've noted that on my spreadsheets. So now that I have spent the time to do this, If you are a student who was with us the first week of school, yours is now considered late. You can click on that link. It'll bring you to a Google form. You need to do a one-page reflection and turn in your assignment. That's how I will check it and change your grade on Aries. If you are a brand new student, meaning I just got you a day or two ago, then you have extra time. Just let me know when you're finished with those. Okay, yellow. Teachers and you, some people are noting that distance learning is actually more work. And, you know, that's my case. You know, I'm working pretty hard, so be patient. But this also means if you have not turned it in, you can still turn it in for full credit. Hopefully I get to it tomorrow. If I don't, that's okay, but I'm kind of encouraging yellow light. It's coming soon, so turn it in now. All right, week number four, okay? So we've completed lesson 1.4 on Friday, or I assigned it. Some of you have done it, some of you have not. That's okay. I'll show you guys a week at a glance. Homework number 1.4, and all of these will be due not this Friday, but the following Friday, next Friday, okay? Because we're going to have a quiz on that day. So I kind of want you to use the lessons and homeworks to kind of study, and that's when I'll collect those. What are we learning this week? We are answering the essential question, how do you display and interpret quantitative data, specifically stem and leaves, histograms, and also talking about more measuring of the center. Okay, here's my little calendar. So today we're gonna do a Khan Academy day. Just like in your warm-up, hopefully you've changed your name so it doesn't say your student ID number, but actually goes last name, comma, first name. If you haven't done that, go ahead and change it. And you've already signed up for Khan Academy, so I just you can click on that. You can read the slides. I don't like it when I'm in a meeting and someone just reads me the slides because I can actually read myself. But I just want to tell you the top three mistakes for Khan Academy. Number one, you're watching whatever you want. You're not supposed to do that. You're only going to watch, read, and practice problems that I assign. Okay. Number two, how do you get minutes? Because in this class, it's minutes. Well, if you were in my class last year, go ahead and unmute. Last year, it was 2 hours per month, and now we're only doing 1 hour per month. Can I get it? Yay! Some people are happy about that. So, what can you do for minutes? So each month, you need 60 minutes. August has already finished, and I haven't checked in, and I didn't assign stuff until this weekend because I needed everybody to sign up first. So by the end of September, you need 120 minutes. And then after that, it's 60 minutes a month, right? 60 minutes for August, 60 minutes for September, okay? So what can you do for minutes? Minutes, you can do reading articles I assigned, videos that I assigned, and practice problems that I assigned. So you can do any of those for learning minutes, okay? You can even get ahead if you need to, but the goal of Khan Academy is actually for you to kind of like review and also relearn topics in a different angle. Maybe you don't like the way I teach or approach it. Mr. Khan can also teach you as well. And then the third thing for Khan Academy minutes is, you know, it's not a perfect system. I don't work for them. And so sometimes students say there's discrepancy of minutes. We're not going to be doing screenshots, but just I would recommend maybe doing 15 minutes over what I'm asking you. So for example, in September, on your computer screen, maybe it says 200, maybe on mine it says 190. We haven't found a perfect solution, but I think that's better than getting rid of it, okay? So today, I'm gonna release you in about 2 minutes and you get to go work on Khan Academy or any other assignments. Here in blue, if I've linked it, that means it's live. So if you already watched lesson 1.4 last week on stem plots, you can now do the homework. There's three questions on that. I need to record lesson 1.5 tomorrow and then post homework 1.5, and then I need to record lesson 1.6. I'll probably do that on Thursday. So again, the distance learning is kind of like almost a college environment where you kind of make your own schedule. For some of you, that helps you that I kind of give you something to do every day, and some of you are like, I just focus on one class, and I spend like 5 hours, and then I take a break, and then do another 5 hours for another class. So you can kind of work at your own pace in that way.